Rula's kind of, she's really getting up the crack of my ass. I think that she's from another time and another environment, and she's not very adaptive. I think Rula had blessed the day that I had left, but now it's kind of funny to see the tables turn and she's been nominated. I think that's hilarious. And then to see her reaction to it, she's fallen to bits mentally and suddenly changed her behaviour code and is floating around like, I was just very actressy. And it's funny to see Traci break down. I found Traci to be, when she's drunk. Traci typifies to me every bad thing I've thought about Los Angeles. You scratch the surface and below it there's more surface. You know, she's probably a nice girl, but I'll never know her, and I don't think she'll ever know herself because she's from Hollywood. And when she was nominated, she sobbed and she kept me awake for the entire night going, I was nominated, I've been rejected by the whole world. And I said, look, I've been nominated twice. She was like, but it's not the same for you. I was actually really nasty to Traci because I just thought she needed a verbal slapping. And I was trying to distract her from her whining by making her angry, but it didn't work. She was too drunk by that time. Well, there's no sense, there's no feeling. With Rula, it's like, oh, just leave me alone. She follows me round all the time. Anything I do, I'm going to see her watching. She's got a look of absolute contempt in her eye. She really doesn't, I don't think she understands this. She doesn't like me, but she's fascinated by me, so she can't keep off my back. And every time she's in a room, I just want to leave the room. I can't stand the sound of her voice booming over everything in that theatre way. She practically comes out of the bedroom going, what's my motivation, darling? Ugh.